Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with a new Hibernate tip. This time I want to show you how to use standard database functions in your JPQL query. Even though JPQL is not as powerful as SQL, there are several functions that you can use within your query. You can use a set of aggregate functions like count or sum, which work on a set of values and aggregate them into one. JPA also supports a set of functions to do basic string manipulation. And you can also determine the length of the string or get the index of a substring within the selected string. These arithmetic functions allow you to implement some more complex calculations. And JPA also supports a set of very useful daytime functions, which you can use to get the current date, time, or timestamp from the database. But be careful, this function gets executed by the database and might return a different time than your Java application. The case expressions allow you to implement simple control structures like if statements and handling of null values. And the last type of functions supported by JPA that I want to show you is the type expression. It returns the type of a specific argument, which you can use to adapt your query to specific entity types within an inheritance hierarchy. As you have seen, JPA supports quite a few functions which you can use to implement complex queries, and Hibernate supports even more of them. Hibernate offers additional functions to determine the length of a binary data and to cast elements to different data types. And it also offers functions to extract certain parts of a daytime value. Okay, but that is enough theory. Let's take a look at a code sample. This JPQL query calls the size function on the books association. As you can see, you can use the function in the same way as you would call a function in an SQL query. But the size function is JPA specific and not available in SQL. You can use it to count the elements in a mapped association. As you can see in the log message, Hibernate generates a join statement to join the associated table and calls the SQL count function to count the number of associated records in the book table. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate, a printable PDF version of this Hibernate tip, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!